Hey, you guys. Let's do a Halloween video. Here's a bubblegum I'm chewing tonight, by the way. Big Lake Chew. Gumbo grape. Bubblegum. Lipstick. It says black lipstick from the spirit store. It says rogue. Oh my god. Honestly, I think next time I'm just gonna get a white wig, and then spray it with hairspray color. Make it the color I want, because the costume wig caps are very uncomfortable. Anyway, let's take my nail polish off. See how that goes. That might be fun. And we can. Where's my little hair wear? Oops. A short spooky story about mom's scary boyfriend. This is a Reddit find. I'll post the credit below. I don't see it here on the page. My mom's scary boyfriend. About 5 years ago, my mom started dating a guy she met on a dating site. Well, that part is fine. I had recently started dating the woman who would later become my wife, and we had met online. I'll just refer to her as my wife for this story. Anyway, my wife and I never really liked this guy. We didn't think he was mean or anything like that. He was just a little creepy. He was quiet. He kept his eyes closed a lot, and occasionally said odd things, like offering my wife a piece of chocolate, then as he let it melt slowly in his mouth. One time, my wife and I were visiting my mom, but she got called into work, so we waited at her house till she got home, and her boyfriend was over, but he spent the entire several hours hanging out in her bedroom with the doors closed. Just before Christmas, my mom and this guy started having difficulties. My wife and I were visiting her for the holidays, and she dumped all her problems on us. And we listened carefully and told her our opinions and suggested that she'd be better off without him. She already had her mind made up, though, and decided Christmas Eve. We spent the night at my mom's house and got up early on Christmas morning to visit my dad at his house. We didn't plan to spend the night at my dad's house, but we got snowed in, which was actually a very nice Christmas surprise. The next day, we left as soon as we could get through the snow. My wife suggested that we stop by my mom's house on the way so we could see if she was okay. My wife just had a really bad feeling about my mom's now ex-boyfriend. My mom's car was in the driveway, but that doesn't mean much because she lives close enough to work that she often just walks in, and it hadn't snowed in her town recently. She also never locks her doors, which drives me crazy. So we let ourselves in, and that's when we see blood oozing out of the refrigerator's water dispenser. It had filled up the spill container and was leaking onto the floor and had made puddle. My wife screamed and I freaked out. I fully expected to see my mom's head in the freezer. I nervously opened the freezer door to find a bag of frozen cherries that had been opened and crammed into the freezer so that it fell onto the ice dispenser and melted. We thought my mom was decapitated by her creepy ex-boyfriend. Terrible. Okay, so what happened was I did a fail video. I was taping my nail polish video. Obviously, I wasn't. So today, let's remove some nail polish. We'll start there. We'll start with my Walmart regular cotton mounds. Whispering That's how I smelled it. Is that bad? Is that like sniffing glue? Let's see. It smells just like a brand new bottle of nail polish, so I mean nail polish remover, so I'm guessing it doesn't go bad. Again, I want to thank the viewer who complimented my fingernails the other day. I can't tell you how confident boosting that was. I complimented at my healthy, long, natural fingernails, which I do take pride in, but because of my fat chunky fingers and fat chunky hands, especially recently, I just don't care to focus on my hands. Hey, I'm doing good. I don't even need this really. It just reminds us what a little bit of kindness, an act of kindness, a kind word can do to somebody. I think it just made me so happy. And look, it got me all happy, and I got Halloween nail polish. I got Halloween. We're gonna do some fake fingernail application. I haven't done fingernail stuff in forever. And I think I've always felt sorry for myself because nobody ever said anything nice about my fingernails when so many ASMR artists, if you notice, use fake fingernails. And I don't. And then once you see their real fingernails, in fact, I'm thinking of two ASM artists that, because of that, their real fingernails, which is not relaxing for me. They bite their fingernails so bad, it's beyond the quick. You know how you might accidentally, I guess the saying is, cut your fingernail down to the quick. This is beyond belief. And nothing against people who bite their fingernails, because there's a little known fact. Angelabright, I guess 1990s. I bit my fingernails my whole life. I have no idea why, other than I notice it runs on my dad's side of the family. I just thought, oh, it's just one of those things. But I used to commute a lot back in the day. I was a commuter. And I realized the things I used to do to keep me awake was I used to chew bubblegum and, believe it or not, bite my fingernails. It was terrible. So anyways, now you know. And then something happened. early 2000s. And everything changed. It's like, it seems like my fingernails were easy to grow. They were harder and stronger and healthier, and I don't even know why. And then it just happened. And I really can't say what exactly happened, but since the early 2000s, it seems it's been easy to grow my fingernails. Okay, so there's that. Now, let's get rid of that. Never know what I'm going to use my makeup brushes for. Spine creasing, keyboard dusting. See all our things. I think I'm gonna try black. I kind of refrain from too much nail filing. I always remember a longtime viewer, Crystal, who was not. Like to know. See, I'm right-handed, so these nails are always shorter from so much rough and tough activity. So I'm guessing that's why I right hand. Okay, so I'll shut. So I have some black. Can you see that? Okay. I used to go. Do you guys know I used to go for a professional manicure every week, late 80s, early 90s, hoping that would help me grow my fingernails. It really didn't, you know, it kept them nice and healthy, but once a week. I used to work in Santa Barbara at the time, and once a week I'd go early for my manicures, and once a month pedicure. You guys see that okay? And how my schedule has changed over the years. myself my own pedicure like every night. I've been buying this foot cream, it's Amazon foot cream. And every night when I'm watching TV, I'm like, I can't leave my feet alone. I rub that stuff all over my feet night after night, watching TV. And I think I've gotten like 3 or 4 jars of it. I'll show it. I just bought another one on my Amazon. I'll show you that one jar again by O'Keefe. Oh. Oh, it really bothers me when I get middle. Mess up. And another fun fact, my whole life, the only nail polish I ever wore in public was white, a pearl, and clear nail polish, or white pearl. And then of all things, on my wedding day, I had fake fingernails for my wedding. And they were brown because my wedding, color of my wedding was blue and brown. It was a very pretty blue and brown color. I've always loved blue and brown. And I could just kick myself because my jewelry was white pearl earrings, white pearl necklace. For the life of me, never know why on that day I didn't wear my white pearl nail polish, other than I wanted fake fingernails, and I never had before either. And wanted the color to match the colors of my wedding. I don't know. Here I am with 2020 hindsight, in the year 2020, I can see so much more clearly now. I think I should have worn my white pearl polish. Prior to this, I think the only nail polish video I ever had was me applying the white pearl polish. And then the other fingernail video I had was a fake press on nails about a month or two ago. Now this. So now what do we do? Yeah. Mm-hmm. I kind of like the two-toned. It's like, oh no, I'm not. Lipstick doesn't go on the moist part of your lip. So there, while I was trying to perfect my black lipstick, I imperfected my Maybe that's why I don't do too many nail polish. Videos, it is a little bit stressful because I want it to be like perfect, of course. That's not gonna happen. So we did good.